she is called the First Lady of British musical theatre, and Elaine Paige is responsible for creating some of the most iconic roles of all time. She was the first actor to play the lead in Evita and Grisabella in Cats. Elaine is in the country for a series of special shows, and she joins us now in the studio. Your voice, oh my God, it is so big. And I hope you don't mind me saying that you are a tiny woman.
Oh, well, I'm not quite as tiny as I used to be, but I am only 4'11" tall.
Where does that sound come from?
Well, there's a key in my back.
I could watch that. I could watch and listen to that all day. By the way, how did you keep the frock on?
I mean, as you can see, I was kind of poured into it.
Oh, just look at that, that power. When did you first realise you had this extraordinary voice with such magnetism and energy?
Well, I think probably it was my first major role in a musical in the West End of London. We've got a theatre that Bonnie knows about there called Drury Lane Theatre, which is a huge barn of a theatre. And I was playing this kind of rather blousy character called Rita in a musical called Billy. And so she was, as I say, kind of a blousy character who was very loud and leery. And I was, you know, I had one song only to sing in the show, but I sang it and, you know, gave it gusto and everything. And the director said to me, do you know what? I think you could do this without a mic. You don't need a mic. And it was then that I discovered that I had this big voice. Because it's looking out at that cavernous theatre, it made you want to sing out, you know.
Yeah, it's a big theatre.
Just extraordinary.
Yeah,
this is a bit of a reunion of sorts, isn't it? Because you and Bonnie go way back.
We do, darling, don't we?
We do.
Well, I don't know how far, but plenty of years.
I remember, I mean, when we did that series, do you remember? I don't even know what it was called. Well, I know what it was called. One More Time.
One More Time.
And it was before you were fabulously famous.
That's right.
You were a singer and I was a dancer.
That's right.
For Granada.
And Nigel Lithgow choreographed.
He did.
Did he not? Yes,
he did.
We know that man too.
We do know that man quite well.
We know him so well.
Boom.
Terrible.
Do you remember that number you did with him? Years ago, he was actually in
this
a number.
This is with Nigel Lithgow.
Nigel Lithgow.
And you were married for 30 years, 35 years.
How do you know that? You know everything.
But you told me.
A long time ago.
It's just got very awkward very, very quickly.
Yes, and Nigel was in this number. This was One More Time again. And he was wearing... he was trying to play an old guy and you were young, you had rollers in your hair. And I can't remember the number.
I can't remember.
But it was hilarious fun. It was just one of those throwaway 10-30 shows every week, wasn't it?
And then, series, and it actually, it was very successful. It went on and on. We did about three or four series together. So that's where I first met Nigel and then subsequently, of course, Bonnie.
Oh, fantastic.
What history.
I know.
It's amazing. Great to see you.
And we only saw each other in October.
Yes.
At the Royal Albert Hall.
Because
we were sitting next to each other. There was a box and we were kind of sitting next to each other. And it was Cliff's 77th.
It was Cliff Richard's...
77th, I think.
No, he was celebrating 60 years or something in the business. So his show was like every decade as it went on. And there was Bonnie sitting next to me. Went, ah!
And you also spent time at Wimbledon together in the Royal Box.
Oh, we did!
Oh, on occasion, yes, we have.
Yes. We sit next to each other.
What a life. Talk to us about some of your most iconic roles and I suppose some of... the favourite characters that you've played. I mean,
well,
Isabel is up there.
I've been so lucky because I came along at a time when the British musicals were coming to the forefront again. And Evita, of course, is the one that gave me a career in musical theatre. And that always stands out to me as one that I shall remember with great fondness because of that. And then I was lucky enough to follow that up with Cats. So I originated that role as well of Grisabella and got to sing Memory.
When you put on a face like that, all of a sudden, I can just see you doing that. Does it just give you some other
Because you disappear. You watch yourself disappear and this other character come forward with the makeup and the wigs and everything. And that happens in every role you play. So the Cats, of course, was very important to me in that song, Memory. And then I played Norma Desmond in Sunset Boulevard. That was another huge role for me, which took me to Broadway as well. So that was also very special. And PF and Anything Goes, you know, I don't know. Chess, you know, gave me a number one single. So I've been very fortunate in the fact that I kind of was part of that renaissance, if you like, of British musical theatre when Tim Rice and Andrew Lloyd Webber were writing brand new musicals.
And it's extraordinary to think about those musicals, the songs that are just embedded in all of us. But who would have ever thought to put music and words to T.S. Eliot's Cats?
I mean,
that concept, nobody's thinking like that anymore, I don't think.
Well, maybe you're right. Andrew, I think, has always been one step ahead kind of thing. He loves cats. And as a child, he was given that poetry book by T.S. Eliot. So he put those two ideas came together. And as you say, it's sort of inspirational, really, that he would come up with something so unusual.
Mm. But even Evita, the big song.
That was amazing. Mm-hmm. That was amazing.
Just the first time you did that premiere opening night, how did that feel standing up there on the balcony?
Well, it was pretty frightening, really, because I was very high up, only 35 feet up, no rails or anything, and I was wearing this huge copy of a Dior ball gown, which was to the floor, and obviously the theatre was very small backstage, and so what I would have to do was get into this huge ball gown and climb a ladder to get up onto the little bit of the stage, you know, off in the wings, and so every night a guy would be under my skirts, helping me, keeping the skirt away from the ladder as we climbed up the ladder.
Would he hold on to you?
He would hold on to the ladder, but I just... You know, the idea of having a man under my skirt every night was kind of... I thought it was rather funny and thought, I wonder where that man is today.
That's way before OH&S, Occupational Health and Safety.
I've heard a rumour that you might be doing an album with Sir Cliff Richard.
Yeah.
I've just heard this little rumour.
Well, it's a rumour, but it's actually a true rumour.
Oh, good.
But we are both talking about it at the minute. In fact, when I go back from Australia, you know, when I finish this tour here, we're really right in the throes of discussing what we're going to do and so on. I think it'd be rather a good idea because I've sung with him before at in Hyde Park. We have a thing in the summer there called Root of Kings, and Cliff was headlining it, and he said to me, would I like to do it with him? So I did a few songs at the start, and then he came on, and then we sang a couple of duets, and that's where we kind of got the idea to maybe do an album of duets together. So fingers crossed it all comes about. Yeah.
Right.
How fantastic.
So what are you going to do on your tour this time in Australia?
Well, here I'm doing, really, I'm celebrating the songwriters that I listened to through the 70s in my youth, really. And people like Harry Nilsson, Randy Newman, Jim Webb, MacArthur Park, Lennon and McCartney, Bacharach and David. It's all of these guys, you know, Carly Simon, Carol King. It's really the soundtrack to our lives, you know. Anybody that's my age will remember all these songs. Paul Simon, I do 50 Ways to Leave Your Lover. And in between all of these lovely songs that I think it was the window of time in my life when I was listening to a lot of music, and these were the songs I was listening to. And, so that's what I'm doing, interspersed with anecdotes and stories about the people that I've met along the way in my career and these songs, because I've interviewed nearly all of these people as well for my radio show in London. And, so it's a sort of an intimate evening of chat and conversation and anecdotes and some songs, of course, as well as the musical theatre songs that I'm known for. I can't leave those out, can I?
Absolutely not. How fantastic. Elaine kicks off her Aussie tour tonight in Sydney. Head to mjrpresents.com for all the details. What a pleasure to have you in our little studio.
Thank you. Thank you so much.